August 1987, Romford in England, and Brian Campbell's in his back garden and he's trying to dig up the trees down at the roots, digging his shovel into the clay and the soils binding those roots, and he hits something metal. Curious, he bends down, leans in to pick up the object. Now that object looked just like this. Give or take a couple of very subtle differences, I'll come to those shortly. Brian assumed it was a blacksmith measuring tool of relatively recent construction. He stuck it on the windowsill in his house and remained blissfully unaware that he had inadvertently found an object that had baffled archaeologists and antiquarians for the last 290 years. This remains one of the most illogical mysteries. How can an object so distinct have puzzled the community for so long? You're rarely 5 minutes from the next news article, the next theory, and yet no one can provide cast iron evidence as to its function. Welcome to the story of the Roman Dodecahedron. So let's step back 290 years or so. In fact, let's step back to 1739, and a curious object is handed in to the Society of Antiquities. The object was found in a field in Hertfordshire, along with a number of copper coins by Mr. North. The Society exhibited them on the 28th of June 1739. Now, before I tell you that since that point, 132 more of these have been found, and before I tell you that they were all dated to the Roman era, and before I tell you that they were found between Hadrian's Wall in the north, right down as far as Hungary in the east, and yet none found in Italy itself and northern Africa, but before I tell you all that, I want to give you a little bit of context and add something to this journey. This is a Roman road between Salisbury and Badbury Rings, part of the route from London to Dorchester on one of the Roman itineraries. I'll try and show you as much of this as I can on today's journey about this. Right, so let's show you what this road looks like. If I come down here off of the now byway, well, you can see a line there. I really hope you can see a line there. That is the top part of the agger of the Roman road. Now this sits on a slope anyway, so it would have been easy for them to pack almost a terrace, but it is an agger. Looks really prominent. If I come down here, I'm probably 5 feet lower. Really beautiful. Loads more examples to come. So these objects, they have been found in riverbeds, military camps, hoards, baths, amphitheatres, tombs, temples, and even a filled well. And what confuses everybody the most? Not once has this been written about by any Roman contemporary sources, no historian or otherwise.
Well, that is quite the mystery. So exactly is this Roman object for? And why does it keep propping up in the media time and time again?
May 1768, Carmarthen in South Wales, St Peter's Churchyard to be precise. Now a grave was being dug out, similar to that of Brian Campbell, an object was struck. The assumption was a rock of some kind, however, upon inspection, the most curious object.
Just like this, and just like Mr. North over in Hertfordshire. And the Society of Antiquities would later describe this as
a singular object of bronze in form and hollow dodecahedron with a ball attached to each angle. Each of its pentangular sides is pierced with a circular opening and the diameters of each of the perforations increasing gradually from 6/10 to 1.5 inches. Each side measures in diameter 2 1/5 inches. So for us, let's call that somewhere between a golf ball and a baseball.
So let's head back to Brian Campbell of Romford, Essex, England. Now, Brian, in 1997, 10 years after he found his object, he was visiting a friend in Germany and they took him to see a Roman fort and a museum. And in that museum, they had one of these. And of course, Brian clocked it, put two and two together and realised that he had one such 290-year-old mystery. On his windowsill back at home, he had an object there that was 1,700 years old. Now, I'm going to pop that in my pocket because I'm going to show you perhaps, and I say this quite a lot, but perhaps one of the most well-preserved pieces of Roman road you'll ever see. Here we are, huge bank. I'm going to climb up it to show you the size of this agger. It's at least 6 foot high, slightly less on the far side just there, maybe 3 or 4 feet, which shows you the level of the hill that it's on. But nevertheless, such an amazing piece of Roman road here. And this will have, as I said earlier, maybe 300 years of repairs and layers upon and upon and upon.
So let's jump forward to today. Well, January this year, in fact, 2024, a few miles south of Lincoln in a village called Norton Disney. Britain's 33rd Roman dodecahedron was found.
No, I haven't got a clue what it is either, but it's been several months since this Roman artifact was discovered in a field in Lincolnshire.
It conformed to all the usual rules of the object, aside the fact that it was absolutely huge.
So not only do we have another dot on the map, but we've also found one of the largest Roman dodecahedrons to be found, probably twice as big as this one. And there's something else as well. It's found discarded in what appears to be an old quarry or pit, along with some discarded broken pottery. Here I am in my element. I really am, because this is yet another wonderful stretch of Roman road. Probably never come out on camera as ever, but I'm sort of 6 feet higher than the path just down there. I could walk along this stretch for miles, I think. So before we delve deeper, let's flip everything on its head. You see, this object is a Roman dodecahedron. Now, a dodecahedron simply describes a shape with 12 sides, but this is so much more. It's got the balls on the outside, the intricacy of the holes.
Secondly, is it actually Roman? You see, researching this has been difficult, trying to find information on each of the 130 or so that have been found, largely because most of them weren't excavated in a modern archaeological way. The newspaper coverage seems to steal all of the headlines and all of the right routes for research.
But we do have a map which details every find of one of these objects, and while that brings up a whole new light on the topic.
The map shows they are clearly found in the northern and western provinces of the Roman Empire. That's not to say that none were ever in what is Italy now, but we can probably safely assume that they didn't come from Rome.
So we have Roman by era, we have dodecahedron by shape, but we still have no idea what it's for. That's certainly not for lack of trying. Now, it isn't the purpose of this video to go over every single theory, because there are literally hundreds. Here, however, is a very short list.
An implement to aid knitting, maybe specifically to gloves because of the holes?
I kind of feel it's too intricate a device just for knitting. Even if it was specifically for gloves, hands are a different size, fingers different sizes, which could represent the different size of objects, of course, but there was no wear. None of these have a wear where you would expect it. And of course, it would have been all over the Roman Empire.
A device for predicting when to plant your crops based on the height of the sun.
Could work, I guess, but again, if it was a successful, really well manufactured thing that could do that, well, I feel, it, again, would have been all over the Roman Empire.
A toy for children, some kind of game or some kind of dice perhaps?
Again, I like that idea, but you have to imagine because the holes are a different size, it would always be weighted to land on one particular angle. And of course, there are no numbers or anything on there that would give us a clue to how that would work. So you can really see the issues I'm having with this. All of these theories seem to fall down in one place or another. Lack of writing, lack of varied locations for these are all quite specific. Lack of wear on the object itself, the inconsistency of sizes, and the lack of markings whatsoever. There's quite a few mysteries left to unravel, but I think, however, that does point us in one direction. There is something else we've yet to consider.
The clue could be in this object. This is the icosahedron, and for all intents and purposes it looks almost the same, apart from the holes are a lot smaller. In fact, when this was found in Germany, it was misclassified as a dodecahedron. But it's not. This object has 20 sides, not 12. Now, only one of these has been found to date. It has those tiny holes instead of the large, but it's the same object, isn't it?
So for every single purpose we have covered, every single projection of what this was for, it has a specific goal in mind, a purpose. And then of course we have the icosahedron, the 20-sided object. Well, and that in my mind blows every theory for this object out of the water. Apart from one, you see, if we assume the icosahedron and the dodecahedron had the same purpose, well then all of the features on the dodecahedron, the nodules, the varying size holes, well, they are indeed, as we said, blown out of the water, and every theory goes away with that. So potentially, when you combine that with the fact that they were found only in what we would perceive as to be sort of Celtic areas, well then perhaps we are reverting to the original archaeologist's cliche, which was, of course, that this has a religious purpose or a symbolic purpose. And I think when you consider those factors we've considered today, that perhaps this was indeed something that was of the, not of Roman origin, but perhaps something that served on into that period, but was very much a Celtic tradition or a symbol for them themselves. Now, if you like a good Roman mystery and you've enjoyed this video, appreciate you watching, click on that video there to find out how to find a lost Roman amphitheatre. Thanks for watching.